Good morning, Canes. Welcome to BNN News 2018. Today is Thursday the 25th, day one, and I'm Kalichi.
And I'm Lexi.
So, Lexi, any news for us this week?
Well, an explosive device was detonated near a JCPenney store at the Eagle Ridge Mall in Lake Wales, according to authorities. The Lake Wales Fire Department was called to the mall just before 5:30 p.m. after an alarm was set off, and the mall was evacuated.
Any injuries?
Well, when firefighters arrived, they found smoke coming from a corridor next to the mall entrance of the department store. An explosive device had been detonated in the corridor, and a backpack containing other possible explosive devices was found as well. There was also damage to the ceiling and possibly to the wall, but no injuries were reported from the explosion.
Well, that's good to hear that no one was injured. In other news, in Alaska, there is a 7.8 magnitude earthquake along the coast, which could lead to a tsunami. Many states by the Pacific Ocean were under watch on Tuesday morning.
In other news, the second highest 2018 basketball prospect Zion Williamson has finally committed to Duke University and now teaming up with the number one player, RJ Barrett. Now for your BNN News Weather Report, here's Mason, the weatherman.
Good morning, everyone. This week in Tampa Bay area, we have some large scale of warm weather compared to last week. Temperature will be around 60 to 76 Fahrenheit, very sunny and warm, but we estimate that there may be some rain started from Sunday, and it will be frequent for next week. The humidity is around 50 to 60 Fahrenheit, so in general it will be a very damp and wet for the next few days. Best time for gardening is coming. That's it, see you guys next week and back to you. Lexi.
Thanks, Mason. Please come out today to support your girls and boys basketball team against Keswick. It's a home game.
Now, please watch the interview with the people who went to the March for Life. The students from March for Life just came back and we're about to interview them. So, Michael, how was the March for Life trip?
It was fun, you know. We marched and we got to listen to President Trump speak, you know. That was really cool. He live streamed to us during the march.
Any memorable experiences you have?
Just walking through the march and seeing, like, people from our side of the, like, from where we live, like, people from my church and everything, marching with their groups and, like, being able to see them and that big of people, you know, just was pretty cool.
So, did you meet anyone new?
Yeah, met a couple new people from, like, Louisiana and West Virginia and stuff. They're pretty cool.
That's nice to hear. I'm with Leah, and I'm going to ask her how her trip was.
Hi.
What did you do?
We marched for the end of abortion.
Did you do anything else besides marching?
I did have a dance-off with a guy in the metro station. Yeah.
So, how was your experience meeting other people there?
It was really inspiring seeing everyone come together and march for one purpose, and it was very loving.
That's amazing. I'm with AJ, and he's going to tell me about his time at March for Life.
It was a good experience. There were a lot of protests, and the atmosphere was great. Like all the schools, like cares, like everything. I thought it was enjoyable, and I thought it was a great time in DC.
That's amazing. Thank you for your time. I'm with Mr. Gotch, head of the theology department.
Hi, I'm Mr. Gotch.
How was your trip?
It was great. We had an awesome time.
Can you tell me more about, like, the things you did?
Well, I mean, the most important thing was we stood up for life by marching with about 300,000 people to the Supreme Court and the Capitol building so that our voices could be heard that we want to put an end to abortion. That was the most important thing we did.
That is amazing. Anything else that you did there, like the people you met? How was their experience?
Well, we did a whole lot of stuff. The kids were tired because we were up early and we were out late. But it was interesting. We met a person coming off of the metro, and he worked for a congressman in California, and he was so thankful for us marching in the life, because it really makes a difference, and it makes his job easier in trying to help his congressman pass pro-life bills. So that was really cool.
That's amazing to hear. Thank you, Mr. Grosch.
Thanks.
Welcome back. Thank you for watching the BNN News this week. See you next week, Canes.